Well, hi there, folks. This is your host, ID Jester. Welcome back. Marvel Heroes. Looking at another hero. This one happens to be Nova. Nova Nova. Yeah, look at him. Look at me. I'm Nova. Anyways, I'll go ahead and look at his item. So, this will be the first hero. The very first hero. We looked at items for them that we actually have an item that is not for the hero. I actually kept it for a long time. I actually was working on him the other day and didn't get a chance to do the
Stand
video recording.
Supplementary up.
But his number one slot item doesn't do anything for powers that we need for the build that I'm using for him. And there's basically two different builds, and we'll talk about that when we talk about powers. So you will see I have an any hero item in there. If you come across his number one slot item and you don't have a destroyer energy rifle, you can just use that. You just won't get the bonus. You won't get all the ranks into the powers that we need. But of course, this has energy damage, critical, and brutal damage, etc. The rest of his items are just fine. They work very well. We are using the Insignia Quicksilver for the movement powers because he is all about the move. If you like very fast characters that move around really fast, you will love Nova. That's his claim to fame. I need to put a pet on him, don't I? He does some range damage, and he also does some melee damage. In fact, we are mostly working on melee at this point. He does have one range power. I should probably switch that out to a melee power or energy, because that is what his is. He uses the Fire Barrage, which is a halfway decent U-Force. Normal items, nothing special. He actually has one that's blessed. I took this off of Scarlet Witch, which we just looked at her just a minute ago. And the reason she doesn't need this is she doesn't have any spirit issues. Nova Magman has spirit issues. So the fact that we can recover spirit every time we hit is a big boost to him. So he does have a blessing and this one special item. The rest are kind of just regular. No legendary, so of course if you gave him the best items and a legendary, he'd be a lot better statted out. Damage reduction 30%. Horrible, horrible, horrible. Damage 2251. Not that great either. So definitely low numbers here. Probably we'll adjust that once we put a pet in. We might get some better stats. As far as his regular stats go, his most important ones, of course, at level 60 are his critical hit rating, which is 46.4, respectable, not a problem, and his brutal strike rating is 29.4, which is a little low, actually. If we were to add 15 more points in blessings, that would only bring us up to about 45% chance. Of course, that might get bumped up when we put in some of the specialer items for him. So just the way he's built right now, he's a little low on everything, so just keep that in mind as we do some gameplay. His core critical hit rating, we actually need the critical hit rating on this character because his critical hit rating is abysmal at this point. So hopefully they'll update him sometime, and his core isn't very good either. So he definitely could do a little bit more work with him to get him a little bit better. Which, of course, we might do once we get through all of our 53 heroes, look at them. Right now, I'm just kind of focusing in on getting them the best way possible. Let's look at his powers. So there's basically two different builds with him. One consists of using all these pulsars and beams, and you're going to throw out a lot of things and have lots of area attack going on. And then the other thing is you have like a melee build where you're actually, you know, doing melee attacks and getting bonuses to your melee attacks and a little human rocket we're moving around. Interesting enough, if you look at his signature power, it actually gives you an extra damage bonus to melee powers. There's no bonus whatsoever in the Cosmic Blaster, which almost I think tends to make you think that the melee power build is a little bit stronger. So that's what I decided to go with. Of course, you could have another build. In fact, I think we actually have another build Maybe I don't. Sorry. Another build with just the different kinds of pulsars you can throw out. They do some pretty good damage. As far as our regular attack, we use a melee cosmic combo. This power is really, really good because even though it's a melee attack, you will basically dash over to the enemy and then punch him. So you can like literally go from one side to the other side back and forth with a melee attack, which is very unique power. He has a lunge forward power, which we actually have a few points in. Because it does some serious damage, is because it will activate pulsars. We do have one pulsar. We have enough points that we can get one pulsar going out, but we're not just all pulsar build. Our next power is a falling star. This power is awesome. Does some really good damage. It weakens enemies, but the main thing is it detonates all pulsars. The problem with the pulsars are they have a delay. You can see there's a 6.4 second delay there. This one has 6.4 second delay. This one here has a, that's a toggle on, toggle off. This one here is a 6.4. So basically you throw out all your pulsars, they have 6.4 seconds before they activate. This one, you throw out your pulsars, and you would actually use Falling Star, and that detonates and activates all your pulsars immediately. You don't have to wait 6.4 seconds. So that's one thing it does. But it also weakens enemies, does some pretty good damage, lets you jump around the battlefield. It is a movement power, which will proc all of our movement power abilities. Let's see, what else? We looked at our signature power a little bit. Gives a nice energy damage, and then gives you a nice little buff for 6 seconds. And some movement speed addition. And a 35-second cooldown. I wish that was 30 seconds, but you know, 35 seconds, whatever. He has this power here, the Cosmic Resilience. We only have a couple points into it, I believe just one point. But the thing with Nova is he's got this shield that'll absorb incoming damage. That's why his damage, or his health is so low, and his defenses are so low. You compensate for that by having this shield, which will absorb damage. And you'll see as the damage you take will flash down. Well, this power here will let you immediately regenerate all your shield, and it makes you immune to crowd control. There is a 12-second delay on this, so you can't just spam this over and over again. So this power actually might be worth putting a lot more points into because you'll get a lot bigger shield. And then lastly, we have our Megatron Pulsar. We'll throw this out whenever it's off of cooldown. There is a 6-second cooldown. Just let it auto, you know, delay the pulsar for 6.4 seconds. Or if we're lucky enough, we use the falling star a lot. It'll detonate immediately. And the other thing that happens when this power activates, I believe, is yes, all other powers have no cooldown or spirit cost. So what you do is you activate your signature power and you literally throw out 20, well, all right, that's over-exaggerated, about 5 or 6 pulsars, because it only lasts for 6 seconds. So you can maybe throw out 4 or 5 pulsars. It doesn't cost you anything, and there's no cooldown on it. So you activate your signature power, throw out a bunch of pulsars, and then you use your falling star power to activate all those pulsars, and then they're going to be doing lots of damage. And, you know, you get a little bit of buff as well to other things. I do love his little melee cosmic combo. Is probably the best melee attack because you really can't miss. You can't be too far away from your enemies because you'll dash over and hit them. And you'll see that in action in here just a second. And that's pretty much. He's got the Nova Barrier passive power here, which of course we'd like to put a few points into. And then, of course, we have the rocket speed, which is a toggle on, toggle off power. And it's mutually exclusive with the starbound power. So you're either going to use the starbound power and the pulsars, or you're going to use the rocket speed and the melee powers. And you're going to turn one or the other on. I'm going to go ahead and turn that on so I don't forget. And we're going to go ahead and finish looking at the Omega system. Pretty standard. We are using melee, actually, so we're going to use a lot of points there. Trying to get Warpath and Sabretooth, and we're trying to get the Spin Tech. pretty common for an energy character. We're going to go down to the Phoenix Force. We actually have a couple points here in Geonosis for the health and energy damage. We're trying to squeeze out as many points and everything. I did put 40 points into Arcane Attunement because he is so spirit weak, and we use up spirit very quickly with this build. So fortunately, between adding this and that one item that gives you spirit back, he's a little bit better than he was to begin with. Oop. All right, so let's go ahead, and you can see he's a pretty quick character, which is nice if you like playing fast characters. Let's go get him a pet, and then we'll see what we can do with him. I actually have one that gives us a bonus to movement, I thought. There we are. Three fighting. Oh, that's right. The fighting just doesn't help him. Oh, yes, it does. What am I thinking? Two ranks to movement powers, and then a couple that I got rid of, the blue and the purple. So that is probably the best option for him at this point. All right, so we got the punchy power, which you watch here as we just click on a hero or click on an enemy. We'll just dash over real quickly and do punch him. We'll go over to this guy and punch him. At least he's already down. We'll punch this white guy, and then we'll punch these guys. So you can see a little dash over to punch is awesome. You can't miss that attack. Look how fast he does it. So that's that. We have the Falling Star, which we talked about, which is going to be activated here in just a second when I get a good opportunity to show you. Here's a good one. And, oh, wait a minute.
Please, I'm a professional.
Boom, there he comes. Flies up in the air, comes crashing down. Leaves a nice little aura of effect around. And then he has, the other power we didn't actually talk about was the Nova Dash. What you do with this power, again, it's a movement power. You hold it down, you charge it up, and you dash forward. You leave a little trail behind you. Does some good damage. And if you fully charge it up, it does 100% extra damage. So you're going to be using Falling Star and dashing forward all the time. There's your Falling Star. And then we're going to throw out our Pulsars. So we'll throw that out, and we'll just see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Activate. Go. Do something. There you go. So you can see how long the delay is on this. So one of the ways to get around that, as we talked about, was to throw out your Pulsar. And then we're going to use our Falling Boom, and it actually instantly activates it. So that's a really good combo. So you definitely want the Falling Star ability, even if you're using all Pulsars. Because that is going to give you the most bang for your buck, I think. And you can see, I love that little melee attack. I'm just going crazy. Oh, wait, we got a bunch of guys in here. We'll jump on them. Bam. We'll use our signature power. Oh, we killed them all. That's good. I don't see much graphic effect on this signature power. We're going to actually activate it by itself one time here to see. I'm wondering if something happened in the last patch that I accidentally did something with the graphic effect, because I don't actually see anything. It's got 14 second cooldown again. We'll go to an area where we're not being attacked, and we'll activate it here. But I just love that little punch. And then you, like, when you're punching the same guy, you punch him in the front, and then the next time you leap around behind him and punch him in the back, and then you leap again. So it's kind of a back and forth, back and forth. Let's go ahead and fight Venom. I need some chests for this guy, so we need to get throw out our Pulsar. There's our signature power. Again, I didn't see anything. Charge up our, there we go. Throw out our Pulsar again. Hit our signature power. Pulsar, 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 Pulsar. Throw out about five, as many as we can. There we go. And watch them all activate at the same time. See that? So whenever you activate your signature power, you want to find the power that you're going to use to really not cause any spirit issues. Throw out our Pulsar again. And see our shield's down, so we'll activate our shield buff to get our shield working again. Throw out our Pulsar again. It's off the cooldown. So you can see this guy is quite manageable. He's very fast, but you do need to keep track. You need to be watching your bars down here to find out what's on cooldown, what's not on cooldown. Now, enough of cooldown. We're really... come on. Oh, what the hell. Didn't activate it in time. Okay.
Thought you could stop me?
Alright, leap on these guys. There we go. Damage. I just love the fact that you cannot miss a melee attack as you run forward. You notice we are in spirit trouble already. So we're going to have to cool down for a second here. Cool down, cool down, cool down. Get that spirit back. So you can see the problem, I guess, with Nova, unless you give him really good items that are going to give him lots of spirit, he could run into an issue where you're fighting a boss for 30 or 40 seconds, and you run into an issue because we're going to use our pulsars here. We're going to activate them all at the same time. There we go. To take a bunch of our spirits. So again, we got a cooldown issue. We have to just chill out for a second, which is a problem because you want to be doing damage every second you're fighting someone. So if you have to delay... that can be an issue, can't it? Alright, so we're going to activate our signature power here in a second. You can just see him jump, bouncing between guys to punch him. That's just awesome. I love that. That makes him a lot funner to play. Before I activated that power, it was not that fun. So we're going to actually activate this. You see, it does some pretty good damage, but I'm going to activate it in 3, 2, 1. There, I activated it. And it didn't, like... I'm energized, but I don't know where the... Oh, okay. All right. So after 6 seconds, it flashes out. I got it now. Okay. See, I didn't see it when I activated it. And then usually when after I activate it, I'm busy throwing out pulsars, so I didn't get to see the fact that it actually has a delay again. So that's kind of a... I guess that's kind of his thing, is his movement and delay. Some of his powers have that delay. Especially, you know, when you use the little rocket forward power, there's a little delay on that, because you got to charge it up. But I did 1 million there. You see, that's real respectable. 1.5, actually. Just found that there's a 1 million there. That's not bad. I'm not going to complain about a million. I'll activate our signature power. The thing with the signature power is you got to be like 6 seconds before you have to... There was a 3 million right there. That was nice. So, yeah, not bad. And like I said, this is without... we need to start saving people, I guess. We should try to help out people. Alright, so yeah, there's a little bit of delay in most of his powers there, and even when he comes down, you activate it, he disappears off the screen for a second, so hopefully they'll relook at him when his time is ready. Come on, there you go. Another one over here, okay. Just punch all these guys, use a little falling star, it gives us a nice little area of effect afterwards. I think that area of effect slows enemies down. You can see me just darting back and forth between them. That's fun. That is fun. Leap! Boom! In your face. Alright. And we'll go get Taskmaster's group of guys here. Alright, so we're going to activate our signature power, and then we're going to basically spam the whole area with pulsars, or as many as we can. And there they go. They go off, and they have a nice little area of effect. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That's like Christmas lights. It's like a Christmas program going on here. Oh. That's pretty cool. I do like that. And if you use a pulsar build, you'd be using pulsars all over the map all the time. It's definitely interesting. Let's put it that way. I'm not sure it's better than the build that we're doing, but it might be. It's just different. I didn't enjoy it as much. I enjoy punching people in the face with this little leap around power. That is a lot of fun. Alright, so now we're going to throw out some more pulsars. We're going to make Christmas lights everywhere we can. There we go. And then it should all activate about the same time. There we go. That's not bad. Oh, what did we get? We got something there. That might have been hero combinations for something we did. Let's see. Oh, no. It was actually a Taskmaster Fighting for Losers guide. Hey, all right. Finally got us an item. A halfway decent item, actually. So that's good. The question is, can I leap up there? And I'm going to try. Nope. I can't do that. I'm going to try it from over here, though. There's like a tower up here. What I'm going to try and do is get off of me and try and use my falling star up there. Nope, can't do that either. Okay. See, we're taking a lot of damage. Let's go ahead and get our shield back. Oh, yeah, the other thing I forgot to tell you. And this is kind of... What the hell? I'm stuck? I am stuck on... Okay, something there for a second. The other thing with the shield is... And I forgot to mention that. The shield fully regenerates after using a movement power, but there's a 6-second cooldown on that. So if we look at our movement powers, we have 1, 2, 3. We have 3 movement powers that we use all the time. The Falling Star, the Nova Dash, and our little lunge forward power. So every 6 seconds... We're getting that shield re-energized, you know, back to full anyways. So, I guess that's why there's not a lot of... Look at that, I'm just crazy good. Crazy good. Let's see if I can... I can't punch that guy down there, so you can't go from one level to the next level. Like, hit the guys underneath us here. Or, you know, come up here and hit that guy at the top. I just can't do that. But you see me kind of lunging in and out. Back and forth, around behind this guy. So every 6 seconds I do this, of course, our... Go ahead and activate our ultimate, our signature power. Throw down a couple Nova Pulsars. I'm stuck again. What's going on here? This is...
Any more takers?
This is really weird what's going on. Is that me? Okay. The camera got locked on these crates there for a second, and it wouldn't follow my character. That's definitely some buggy things going on with him, I think. Hopefully they fix that. I've never had that happen before, so I apologize. But you do have to be careful, I guess, when you're just trying to make sure. See our... Falling Star power, you know, we can use that about every, what, 5 seconds? Is that what the cooldown, or 4 seconds? I forget what the cooldown is. Yeah, there's nothing up here. We don't need that. So, you notice we had a spirit issue a little bit. But, you know, the changes I made when I was testing Nova, literally after 30 seconds he would be out of spirit. But just a few of those items helped out. That one item specifically, and then... The fact that I put in a few Omega points to get us that extra spirit. So if I can get us a, if I can get him insignia that gives us a lot of spirit, that would be good. Or maybe another item up here that gives you spirit. I think we actually put, let's see. This one here gives us spirit recovery per second. So I added this item and I gave him this item. Those two items specifically. And then I gave him some Omega points, give him 40 extra points in for spirit. So that'll help him last a little bit longer. Of course, you know, if you wanted to get around that, you could just use a basic attack. But you know how I feel about trying to set up heroes without basic attacks. Came all the way over here and there's nobody to shoot. So this is Nova. He's very fast, quick. I love the fact that, you know, just boom, 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 you can, you know, here we are just zooping around the map, just punching people, taking these guys out, you know, and he's powerful enough that it's like, literally like, oh, bosses. We're going to use our ultimate power. Here we go. Let's see. Let's wait until they all kind of gather around. Come on, everybody gather around. There we go. Here we go. Ultimate power. 1, 2, 3. Here we go. Bam. Wasn't that impressive, but definitely Come on. Oh, we did get him in the unique, which is great. Oh, yes, that was one other thing I was going to mention. Oh, good. Maybe another unique for him. Come on, get him, get him, get him, get him. Just being able to dash over there really quickly, falling star in his face. He's got so many good little combos that you can just make him just so fast. You see that? I mean, just taking these guys out left and right. And he's powerful enough without any special items that you can... Oh, let's grab this insignia. I'm actually running out of a lot of resources. See that? I mean, just... See how quick he is. Just get from point A to point B, just wiping these... Of course, they're minions. Yes, I know they're minions, but still. You know, the guy teleported right there. The yellow guy teleported, and when I melee'd attack him, I teleported right next to him, which is, you know, that's... things you don't get in the stats line that says, oh, this is what this character does. It doesn't tell you that, oh, yeah, by the way, you can literally, you know, if an enemy teleports, you can teleport right over to him and continue punching him in the face. If I was Wolverine or another melee character, I wouldn't have that choice. And, if I'm in the middle of my ultimate power as Wolverine and I'm punching him and he teleports away, then I miss my attack, so... Things that, you know, like I said throughout this series, there's little things that go in my head as I'm looking at heroes, and it either, you know, I either say, oh, that's cool, I like that, or it's like, oh, no, I don't like that, and give him a minus. You know, he does have a lot of pluses, so he's not as powerful as some of the other heroes, that is for sure. He does have some spirit issues, but he is fun to play. I will give him credit for that. I will completely give him credit for that. He is powerful enough that he can handle his own. And, you know, having this the issue where, you know, because we use all these melee, these movement powers, we re-energize our shield. You know, our shield stats are really low right now. Our defensive stats, I guess I should say. Oh, here's the spirit issue time. So I just have to chill out. Don't use any powers for a few seconds, and you'll get your spirit back. Try not to lunge around too much. You can run into spirit issues. Of course, if I had 500 or 600 spirit as opposed to 400 spirit, I'd be able to last a lot longer. So that's things to take into consideration when you're building your Nova. But let's go ahead and do this and that. Activate this. It's supposed to be spirit free because I activated her. We got lots of pulsars going on, which is great. He just happened to run away from the area. So I guess that's kind of his deficit. His Nova's issue is a lot of things you have to time. Where are things going to be in 6 seconds from now? Where are things going to be in 3 seconds from now? When I'm charging up this, if he goes and jumps away, I'm going to have to retarget him. So there, it's very target intense. So you have to make sure, that's something you would like to do with your hero. But he is very quick, he's very fast, he's probably one of the fastest heroes in the game. It's probably a tie between maybe him and Psylocke, although she's probably faster because she teleports when she does her movement. Oh, see, and we're running into another spirit issue. I just didn't wait long enough. So, you know, there could be an issue. I need to have more spirit on him, but you can see we're doing some pretty good damage. We've had a few, you know, quite a few 1 millions flash on the screen, and we had that 1-3 million. And I'm sure with better stats and better items and more blessings, you would get that more damage. And he seems like a very viable character, which I'm surprised, because when I originally played him a long time ago when he first came out, he didn't seem as powerful, so they must have done some update with his items and his powers since his initial release. I think I had played him with the mechanic with the shield, so I remember the shield mechanic. That must have came with his default build. But all the way, you know, like I said, no legendaries. We only do have the one blessing, but, you know, three more blessings, another good item up on top here, and he would be rather good, and we're not even getting any blue or purple item bonuses there, so... Oh, we got another energy destroyer rifle. Look at us go. That was one of the items we picked up. Oh, yes. Everything you've seen here with him is normally when I go through his items, I make sure everything's upgraded to level 60 and upgraded. You notice I actually have a level 56 item here, and I have a level, okay, just 156. So this one hasn't been upgraded to level 60 and then got the item grade up to 66. So it's a little bit less than it would normally be, but I just didn't want to spend all the resources to upgrade it 3 points. I was kind of actually hoping I would find one, and that way it would save me like 200,000 in money to upgrade. It doesn't look like I'm going to end up finding one, but we did find another item for him. Oh, there's, okay, that's great. There is the original, his item slot. You can see it gives you 4 to the Cosmic Blaster powers, which happens to be the Pulsars. And then it gives you 3 ranks to call Scanning Bolt and Pulsar power. So I didn't think what the Pulsar. So you're going to get bonuses with your Pulsars. You're going to get bonus to that whole tree. And then you're going to get a specific Cascading Bolt power, which is this one right here. So definitely if you get this item and you want to do a Pulsar build, you definitely want to keep that item for that. So that's great that that came along, actually. So I could show you guys that. It's interesting, it came after, right after the Energy Destroyer Rifle. So you can kind of get a combination, you can kind of see the reason I went with the Energy Destroyer Rifle. Now this one hasn't been upgraded, and it might end up being actually, you know, more energy damage, more critical damage, more brutal damage. But you still get the +1 to energy, and you get 2 ranks to all powers. So I'd rather take the 2 ranks to all powers with the Energy Destroyer Rifle, so I'm getting 2 ranks to everything, as opposed to some specific ranks in here, which I'm not using. So, Synergy, I don't think we actually talked about Synergy. We're using Cable, Cyclops, Emma Frost, Hulk, Human Torch, Iron Man, Silver Surfer, Squirrel Girl, Star-Lord, Wolverine. Kind of a different combo there than normal. So that's a look at Nova. Hopefully you enjoyed it. We are using, oh yes, last thing, team up. If you got Wasp, you definitely want to use Wasp as a team up, because she actually gives you, when she's away, base damage bonus of 20% for 2 seconds whenever you use a movement power. I don't know, how often do we use movement powers? About every 1 second. So you should probably be getting a lot more damage. So Wasp is the hero you want to use if you have Nova for the movement. If you're not doing all the movement powers and you're focusing in on the Pulsars, you might want to look at a different team-up hero there. But all in all, not bad. I think he's a very viable character. Get this upgraded to level 60. Get him some more spirit. 404 is not that bad. You know, health is not that much, but we do have that huge shield. Our damage reduction is really low because of the fact that we have this shield. If we had a high damage reduction and a shield, we'd be unstoppable. That's for sure. Numbers wise, not bad. Stat wise, not bad. Critical hit. We get the brutal strike a little higher by giving him some items in the legendary. He could be a definite green red raid hero for you. So hopefully you enjoyed it. We got another hero coming out shortly, so thanks for watching, and we'll see you then.